What are you doing here? What do you want?
It doesn't matter. I can and will shoot you where you stand. But just so I know, why are you guys doing this? This isn't your first time either, is it?
Well, I'm looking for something. Something we have to have by tonight. There's no need to shed anybody's blood. We are in a very bad situation.
since this is attempted robbery, armed robbery, that there's no scenario in which I'd just let you go. How do I know you won't return again?
That wasn't us.
I see you both are carrying guns. I gather that probably means that whatever it is you're searching for is certainly of great importance.
Perhaps you're even willing to die for it. Regardless, you're not walking.
Assignment?
Well, you know me. Last minute, baby.
Yep, I do. Hey, have you seen Riley anywhere?
No, actually, I haven't seen Riley or Jessica. We were going to meet here for a little menage a trois fun in the fountain, but your early arrival spoiled that for you.
Sorry.
So, no, thanks, pal. No, but in all seriousness, did you hear anything on that job? Sorry. I didn't know it was a sore subject.
I mean, it's really not. I should have known nothing was going to come out of it. Newspapers are dead anyway, but Riley got one, though, so
oh, nice.
That's awesome.
No, that's great.
Yeah.
Did Kev get a hold of you?
Kevin?
Yeah.
No, was he supposed to?
I actually ran into Kev last night at Reed's. You can believe that. He said we should stop by.
That's interesting. Well, I guess we could go by his house later tonight once you're done with your little paper.
Did you get mine?
No,
I did. Aw, you're gonna make a wonderful wife someday.
Who said anything about marriage?
Well, that's nice.
So what are we gonna do tonight?
Sean said he saw Kevin last night, so I think we're gonna go by his house later.
Oh yeah, you should.
Or I could stay back and we could watch a movie.
Oh, no thanks. I got what I needed.
Alright. I'll be back in an hour. Hey, pick me up later now when we go to the side of that.
How can I help you with Q?
You know, I was wondering, since I've known you for a while, I've actually been in your classes for all 4 years, and I came here on your scholarship program.
Yeah, it's too bad you couldn't maintain that A to keep that scholarship.
Yeah, well, I was kind of hoping you could write me a letter of recommendation.
I'd be glad to. What's the job?
It's actually for a middle school. It's not my major.
Having some troubles?
Yeah, you know, this major really isn't the most enabling one to have right now.
Well, you know, with a little hard work, I think that you'd make a great school teacher.
Thanks, but I can't really afford to go to any more schooling. I already have a bunch of student loans I can't add on top of that.
Yeah, I can understand that. Well, if I can do anything, I'll sure help you out as much as possible.
All right, thank you.
Hey, Q. How'd you like bananas?
Loved it. Morty Allen's the best.
Yeah.
Bananas.
Sometimes it's important to acknowledge movies that simply excel in their genre. Remember, Stroycheck is next week. I'm going to have everybody write on it.
Oh, can't wait. It's always fun trying to figure out what Werner Herzog's trying to say.
Herzog, I bet you he's a big hit.
It's not that bad.
You get the letter about the conferences?
Yeah, that's why I came down.
Just be glad we're not in the public school system anymore.
Every day. We're going to ride up together? The two-hour drive is definitely the worst part.
Yeah, we can take my car. Yeah. Didn't mean to ask you. How's Sarah doing?
Not too bad. She's working the program. I think she's really trying. Sometimes I worry still.
Think she's using again?
Sometimes. Yeah, I do.
Well, you know this, but if there's ever anything I can do.
There's really not. No one can help her until she decides to take recovery seriously. Not even me.
All
All right, I'll be in the morning to pick you up.
Thanks, babe.
Mm-hmm.
Have fun tonight, guys.
Bye, honey.
Oh, man, am I glad to see you guys. It's been way too long.
Yeah, Sean said saw you at Reed's house the other day. Hadn't realized how long
it's so been. Bizarre our friends like us go to the same college and barely ever see each other.
Well, I mean, not to say, Kevin, apart from how toasty warm these windows must be here, it's blanket size, so you're doing all right.
Oh, I like it warm.
Say, what have you been doing now anyways? Did you get a job in your major or something?
No, I majored in education. You realize how much teachers make, right? Especially one just starting out.
Yeah, so if you don't have a job, how are you able to live like this?
You know I smoke, right?
I guess seeing you smoke behind the library for 4 years, so yeah, you could say that.
Well, I bought from the same guy all through college, and I finally just asked if I could buy in bulk.
What exact quantity qualifies as bulk?
Never had a steady job, well, ever. The most money ever given to me was by my grandma when I was born, about $5,000. I never touched it. And then I started thinking, I could really use this money as an investment. So I took out $4,800 and spent it on 2 pounds of grass.
How'd you know you have people to buy it from you?
In this town, seriously, all the guys in the frat house down the street smoke. I smoked with one of the guys from there. Smoking with him one day and mentioned I was going to sell a little weed, and so he spread the word for me. It was gone in less than a week. $1,300, impressive. Easiest money ever made.
I'm guessing that this wasn't a one-time thing then?
How could it be? I kept investing.
Yeah, but if you're selling to the same people all the time, doesn't your profit kind of like plateau?
You're right. The frat house was profitable. They can only smoke so much, try as they might. So I started reaching out all over campus. Listen, this stays between us, right? Well, Brian, he's the guy I buy from. He's the dealer's number two. The dealer started asking questions, and, well, Brian explained.
Yeah, I bet that didn't sit well.
Actually, he reached out and realized that I would work good for his team, and, well, Walt's his name, and he's starting to expand his borders, and he really wants to get his stuff across state lines.
So what's this Walt fella like?
I've never really met the guy. He started when he was young. His parents died when he was like 11 or 12. Funny thing is that he actually caused it.
How's that?
He was out partying when he ran into an older crew, so he tried to impress him and bring him back to his house to smoke his stash, and well, his parents weren't there. He impressed him so much that they came back to rob the place the next day, and his parents were there.
They killed him?
He went from family to family until he graduated, and actually, he was a pretty smart kid. He actually went to school here, and then he got kicked out for selling.
That's tough luck. So how much money are you actually making?
Let's just say that my student loans won't be a problem by the end of the year. Hey, come see what I got.
What about us?
What about you?
You can sell this stuff.
Last I knew, you guys didn't even smoke. I'm not sure you guys know enough to.
What's there to know? I mean, I can use it to scale. I know that some strands are better than others, so they cost more.
If you're truly serious, I can ask Brian to meet with you guys. I won't promise anything, but if you're going to work for Walt, you'll need Brian's approval. Do we make the phone call?
I can't believe you.
What?
You aren't going to sell drugs, so why even bring it up to him? He's gonna take it serious, you know?
Maybe I was serious.
Sean, I know you. You're not that hard. I mean, you cower every single time we wash the wire. Now tell me again that you're actually considering this.
Yeah, Q, I'm considering this. Q, have you taken a look at our student loans? Do you know what they're gonna be? And on top of that, everything else, rent, food, gas. That's a lot of money. That's a considerable amount. I'm gonna listen to what he has to say.
Yeah, I'm fine. It's okay.
You sure?
Yeah, just end of the year stuff. Kind of getting bogged down. Par for the course.
If you say so.
I meet at a flea market, Q.
What do you expect? We're not gonna go to his house. Plus, what a better place for a starter to hang out than a flea market.
Here, you boys want to sell dope.
You mean marijuana, right?
Q. Q, what's that stand for? Queer?
No.
Okay.
So, anyway, sir. Kevin had said that we could,
I don't care what Kevin said. All I care about is you two understand something. This is about business. Kevin may vouch for you, but in the bottom line, it's about business. Man I work for is about business. If you two don't take care of business, business will take care of you, and I shouldn't have to explain what that means. At the end of the day, if you guys don't want to do it, I can have six more guys here to fill your spots. Are you in?
I'm in.
I'm in.
Alright. First item of business. I'm gonna start you all off small, just like I did your buddy Kevin. Start you off 2 pounds, not less than.
Yeah, dude.
Second thing, can't have you guys running around town like a bunch of fools selling weed out of your backpack in all these white neighborhoods. So you're gonna have a cover.
I don't understand. What do you mean by cover?
You don't need to understand. Just know that there's gonna be someone looking over you, making it a little bit easier for you. And you're gonna take a small percentage of what you make.
Guess that makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. Guy's name's Ralph. He doesn't like to be bothered, so don't pester.
And what does Ralph do?
Plus, he owns a drive-in.
Hey, are you coming?
No, go ahead. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay.
Hello?
Hey, Mia, it's...
Jay, I still have your number.
Listen, it's been a long time.
I know. It's nice to hear your voice again.
Mia, there's a reason I called.
Oh?
It's Scott. Something's bothering him. I mean, he's all right and everything.
You don't know what it is? He knows that he can call me.
You know how he is. He doesn't want to bother anybody. He's better at most at taking care of himself, so... That's why it's so strange to see him like this.
I've been meaning to call. Thanks for letting me know, Jay.
I found a summer job. I mean, it's nothing big, it's just something until I find something a little better.
Oh, that's great. Where is it?
Sean and I are working the drive-in. You know the one about 20 minutes from here?
No. Can't say that I do. Do people even still go to the drive-in?
Of course they do. It's an American tradition.
Right.
But I will be working nights, of course.
It's not my favorite, but I want you to do what makes you happy, and this sounds like a pretty good summer job.
Yeah, we'll see. Listen, I do want you to know that I really am trying to find a good job. Just...
I know you are. Don't worry about it. We'll figure it out. Don't get frustrated if it takes longer than you think.
Alright. What are we watching here?
Triple D. It's almost over.
Alright, good. Just make sure that we don't...
The Daily Show or Colbert. Not ever.
You know I love you, right?
I remember the code. When did we start that?
My knee surgery.
Mm-hmm.
I was about to be wheeled back, and I tapped you 3 times. I hadn't told you I loved you before. And honestly, it was the only way I felt comfortable saying that in front of my family. I didn't expect you to catch on, but...
I did immediately. And I did it right back.
Dad?
Mia! Come in, sit down. What are you doing here?
That company is reviewing my resume. They won't have final answer for a few weeks, so I thought I'd come visit you.
Well, you'd be staying with me, right?
Oh, I don't want to put you out.
Oh, yeah, now you're my only daughter. Of course you'll stay with me.
Well, in that case, since I'll be roughing it with you in the wild for a couple weeks, I need to go to the store and get some supplies.
Well, you'll need this.
That's okay, I already have a house key.
I had to change the locks.
Oh? Bad break-in?
No, we had a break-in a few weeks ago.
Why didn't you call me?
Well, I didn't think it was a big deal, and, you know, but since you'll be staying with me, I thought you'd better know.
You know better than to think like that. It won't be long.
Okay, we'll see you in a while. Thinking about taking that position?
I think so.
Well, just letting you know, I can adjust that where necessary.
All right, thank you. Dr. Allen, you've actually helped me out a lot this year. Well, really all 4 years.
Glad to.
Yeah. Oh, and also, I'm sorry about missing class last Thursday. I know I'm supposed to be a part of the debate, so I typed this up for you.
Okay, well, I appreciate it, and I'll consider that when I'm grading the others. No, Q. You really have a lot of problems.
Is this really because I missed one class?
No. I take a vested interest in all my students who come here on the scholarship I give. You should keep that in mind.
Right where we left off.
No, I don't expect that. Listen, I'm sorry for how I was. Just everything in my life was so complicated.
I know. You never would let me help you.
Couldn't. It wasn't your burden.
You shouldn't have turned me away.
I'm sorry I pushed you away. Just everything fell on my shoulders. I didn't want to bring you into that.
I wanted to help you. To be there for you.
I've regretted not letting you ever since.
You could have called me.
I should have.
Cyrus. We are looking for Ralph. Is he here tonight?
Yeah, he is. I'll have to calm him down, though, so is this important? Because he really hates
it. It's important.
What?
I have two guys here, so they need to talk to you.
Do they know I'm busy in here?
Yeah, I mentioned that. They're still here.
Ah, jeez.
It'll be right down. Can I get you guys any food or drinks?
We're alright, thank you.
Are you sure? Because we just introduced this new item to the menu. It's called poutine.
What is poutine?
It is French fries with brown gravy and cheese curds on top.
Is this something you concocted?
No, actually it was Ralph's idea. He's Canadian. Poutine is a Canadian dish, so he insisted we cook it every night we're open.
Does anyone ever order it?
No, actually, it's pretty much just his exclusive dish.
Wait a second, so Ralph's Canadian?
I know. The only main Canadian in existence.
So much for an American tradition.
What do you want?
Yes, you're expecting us?
I wasn't expecting anybody!
Yeah, Brian sent us.
Oh, you should have told me in the first place. Follow me. I assume Brian's told you what you boys will be doing here and what my part is.
Yes. Well, he went over briefly anyway.
Well, briefly should about cover it. You boys will be here doing what you need to do, but don't hassle any of my customers. Because I don't like to get called out of this office, you understand? Good. This is what's going to happen. One of you is going to be standing outside the concession stand. Don't approach anyone, they'll approach you.
Well, how will they know if we haven't been here yet?
You guys think you're the first ones to ever do this here? This has been going on since the 70s. A user can spot a seller.
Okay. So, the customers approach us. And then what? We take them to the bathroom or something?
You want to make money any other way? Let's say,
my name's Sean.
Let's say Sean here's the one outside the concession stand. Somebody approaches you. You're going to contact,
Q.
Q? Okay. You're going to contact Q. Text him or whatever. You're going to take their money. You're going to send them to the car. Q's going to give them their goods. Simple.
So no problems? You never had cops come in here to post as customers?
If you can't spot a cop, you got no business selling. We got police presence here on the premises for about an hour and a half every night. Between the hours of 8 and 10, you ain't gonna sell. We show a triple feature every night, and that should give you boys plenty of time to make all kinds of money. Which brings me to my next point.
Your take.
That's right. I get 15% of everything you earn. You make $40, I get $6. You make $400, I get $60. Which is my fair share for providing an establishment for you boys to commit whatever criminalities you wish to, and to also cover you should it be necessary. But I'm going to tell you one thing right now. I only
hunger for one time.
Yeah, you bring the fuzz down on me. And I'll be all over you like Serpico the whole time. Capiche?
You got it.
Good. One thing. We don't have a whole lot of business here in late March and April. But don't worry about it. Hang in there. Because by May, there'll be more people in here and you boys will probably run out of your stash. All you gotta do is keep an eye out, watch yourselves, and you'll be fine. Understood? Good. Now get out of here. Wait a minute. I forgot something. Your boy's gonna pay every night you come in here.
It's only April. We have plenty of time to make money.
You know, I'd like to at least get one customer. Plus, we're actually losing money because we have to pay to get in here every single night. And how many times have we seen this next movie?
Well, we saw it opening night, and it's played as a second feature for a few times now. So, four?
No, I gotta get something to eat. Something warm.
I'd stay away from that poutine if I were you. This stuff looks nasty.
Hey, you see that car back there?
Yeah? Why?
The car's been the only car here. In fact, every night that we've been here has been the only car here.
Yeah? So?
So why don't we approach him?
Can't do that. Remember what Ralph said? Plus, how do we know he's not some off-duty cop?
An off-duty cop? What kind of cop do you know that goes to the drive-in every single night?
Cops can be movie buffs too, Q.
Oh my, I just want some action.
Whoa, check out Tommy DeVito over here. You know, a month ago I could barely get you to agree to this. Now you're itching for your fix.
Alright, this is our chance. The movie just ended. This is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna go up to him, tell him our car died, ask him if he has any jump rope cables, you know? Scope him out a little bit, see what he's like. After that, I'm gonna ask him if he likes to booze, get inebriated at the drive-in. I don't know what he's into. And then, if he says yes to that, I'll ask him if he smokes. And if he says yes to that, then...
That's a lot of what-ifs. Plus, the car isn't even dead.
Screw it, I'm going.
Q, come on, man. Get back here.
How you doing?
Yeah, I hope
my car died, and I was wondering if you had any jumper cables I could possibly use.
Well, management's got cables if you go ask them.
Yes, yeah, I don't know if you've met the manager, but I was trying to avoid that.
Ralph?
Yeah.
Okay, I gotcha. Right. Hold on.
Oh man, it's brutal. But I love the drive-in too much to care.
Yeah.
Alright, here we go.
Oh, look at that. Nice.
Yeah, comes in handy when you're at the drive-in movie.
Especially in March when no one else may be out here.
Yeah, we're right up here.
Yeah, the only other car here.
Alright. So how do you keep it warm?
Excuse me?
I don't know. I mean, do you ever...
What are you, a cop or something?
What? No, no. I'm not a cop. I'm far from a cop. You know, I could go for a brewski myself right now.
Hey, I love to drink, but not when I'm by myself. And especially not out here where I'm the only driver.
Hey, you're responsible. I can appreciate that. Here we go, right up here. Hey, got the car to start.
All right. Sorry about that. How about this? Let me get you a soda because I made you get out of your car in this weather.
Well, I already have a soda. How about a popcorn?
Sure.
A large?
Yeah, that's fine. Let's go. Come on, Josh.
So, how are you guys liking the movie so far?
It's pretty good.
Dreading the next one, man.
Why's that? Seen it already?
Yeah, that's right.
Same here. But why do you guys stay for the second movie if you don't like it?
Nothing better to do, I guess.
Haven't I seen you guys around here before? Yeah, like several times.
Yeah, I guess so. Q, just get this man his soda or be popcorn or whatever, and just let him enjoy the next movie.
You guys work for Walt.
Walt?
No, man, I don't even know a Walt. In fact, we're unemployed.
What do you know about Walt?
Q! You guys are being a little flagrant, no?
The customer is supposed to approach you.
See, everyone around here knows how to get the stuff if they want it.
Listen, alright. I don't know what you think, but there's no need to... This is just a big misunderstanding.
No. See, you don't think that Walt would give a couple of new guys drugs
and not make sure they were doing what they were supposed to be doing?
Right. So we sent you here to spy on us.
Well, we're not exactly in the most trustworthy business, are we? By the way, name's Frank.
Nice to meet you, Frank.
It was rough my first go, too. Don't worry about it, because all your superhero sequels, those come out in May, and that's your big payday. Alright.
So, Frank, how long have you been in the business, or should I not ask that?
Been working since out of high school. I mean, it's really hard to turn down that kind of money, and I needed it.
That certainly sounds familiar. Popcorn.
Well, don't let me be a bummer to you guys, but let me give you fair warning. There'll come a time, Kimo Sabi, when all this
starts to lose its appeal.
Yeah, well, if that's the case, what are you still doing in the game?
Well, I'll be honest with you. It's because I'm a coward. I don't want to get on Walt's bad side. He doesn't like people leaving on their own terms. Oh, shit. It's like a movie started. See you gentlemen next week.
Hey, I thought we passed the test.
You did. I just really loved the driving. Thanks for the popcorn.
I was wondering if you were going to come by.
Oh, I didn't wake you, did I?
No. You look exhausted here.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm beat.
You want something to drink?
Yeah. Do you have any beer? Thank you.
You haven't finished your job yet?
You know what? It's so cold that it's hard to.
Well, it'll warm up soon and more people will start coming by. Help time pass.
Hey, you two. Always during the first intermission. It's ridiculous.
Hey, Sean, where are you guys at?
We're up here, Frank. Grab your chair, man. You were here Saturday, Frank.
Yeah, I had a wedding to go to. Business still good?
As always, selling out almost every night. I'm seeing double features.
I guess we should be happy about that. It won't be long now.
What won't be long?
Your phone call from Walt. I bet that he's going to move you guys to a bigger area. You and Q have great chemistry.
It really isn't that hard. You think he's going to call?
Definitely.
Hey, Frankie, how's it going, man?
Well enough, well enough. Sean here tells me that you guys are prime time now. Congrats.
I don't know about prime time, but I guess we've hit our stride. Hey, check this out. Did somebody order a large pizza?
Wow, you weren't kidding.
About my sister.
She's not here.
I'm not looking. I want you to stop selling to her.
You don't have the impression I'm selling.
Look, I know she buys from Walt or one of your guys. Look, I'll pay you to stop.
What seems to be the problem, Mr. Campbell? Can't locate your sister?
I came to ask that you stop selling drugs to Sarah.
Get this guy out of here.
You, Walt! I know it's you! Look. You don't need Sarah to fill your quota. And she's gonna die, and you'll lose a customer anyway. Please.
How is it my problem that your sister can't handle her high? If she didn't get it from one of my guys, she'd just find it somewhere else. Look, I know you love your sister, but it's time for you to face facts. Sarah is a junkie beyond help. All you can do now is make sure the funeral arrangements don't land solely on you. I'll tell Sarah you said hi.
Walt!
Come back by tonight?
I don't know, Riley. Does it really matter?
Well, it matters that I'd rather not cave your skull in with a baseball bat thinking you're an intruder, if I can avoid it.
Then don't wait for me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I love you. What are you doing tonight?
I was just about to call you. Guess who's in town?
Who?
Mia.
Really? What's she doing here?
She came to visit her dad. She wants to go out tonight. I told her that I'd call you.
Great. What time?
Just come over when you're ready. Door's open.
You know what, guys?
I don't get it, man. I mean, she's the first to be possessed. Somehow she outlives everyone while they're killing themselves off. She's a druggie, and to top it all off, she comes out the hero in the end. That wouldn't have flown in the original trilogy.
No. You're overanalyzing it. I mean, if you remember, in the second movie, the hero also became possessed, and he had to overcome that.
Yeah, well, I didn't like to.
Yeah, what are you talking about? You didn't like to? Well, no, wait a minute. You like three, don't you?
Frank, there's a reason the third one is so beloved. It's hilarious.
Okay, I agree with you there, but you can't deny
the
first.
Hey, Sean, check your phone.
Is everything okay?
Just got a text from Brian. Said Walt wants to meet with us. Also said there's another money-making opportunity.
Oh, good, you're ready.
You in a hurry?
Nothing special, just that Riley, come on.
Is everything okay?
We really don't have time.
We don't have time for anything. You're always running off. Look, we're graduating soon, and I don't want you to feel overwhelmed, so I made you a new resume, and I found potential links for your jobs, just in case you don't want the one in the middle school.
Thank you. I really appreciate it. But can we please go now?
Guys are doing everything right. Sorry.
Well, so we should go over there once we leave?
Yeah.
It's not like we can't go see him.
No, not at all.
So how was business tonight?
We sold out an hour before closing.
What did I tell you, Brian? These two have got to be the best first timers I've ever seen. And you know I've seen quite a few. Well, I suppose you're curious as to why I brought you here tonight. Simply put, you two impressed me. And I'm not easily impressed. I have a lot of guys working for me. And I like to acknowledge my best soldiers. And you two seem to sell more and more every night.
Well, the drive-in's been pretty good to us.
It certainly has. I can appreciate how you've revitalized an area I started to believe was stagnant.
It's been a good summer for movies, I guess.
Indeed. Look, I'll be frank with you guys. The drive-in seems to be your niche for whatever reason, so I'm going to leave you guys there. However, I do have another proposition for you. Smoke?
No, thank you.
I don't smoke.
First, however, I want to tell you a story about a man named Charlie. Charlie Herman. This man abandoned his wife and young kids 10 years ago. Why would he do this? Because this man is an addict. Heroin was his drug of choice. When you're an addict, you begin to owe the wrong people a lot of money. I told Charlie he had to pay up on his debts if he wanted to maintain his lifestyle. You have to see where this is going by now. Charlie left town. He was not enough of a man to pay his debts and face his creditor.
Sir, what does this have
Just stay with me. I didn't drive Charlie out of town. No pusher wants to lose a heroin addict, for God's sake. That being said, I did what I had to do.
What does that mean?
What kind of businessman would I be if I just let a man leave town without paying his debts? Word would get out that I was lax on enforcement. People would take what they could from me before leaving for the next town. I found him in a town 6 miles west of here. I pulled his teeth out. Honestly, I was probably doing him a favor. Have you ever seen an addict's teeth? So I pulled out his teeth, and then I cut his throat. I took care of Charlie's hands and feet once he was gone. Buried his appendages and tossed the body in the Missouri River. And you know what? Word got out among the other parasites around here. Everyone paid on time and honored their debts. You see, a guy like me does what he has to in order to maintain a sense of order and respect. I need to be able to trust in you guys that you'll take care of the task that I give you. And you, in turn, need to be able to trust in me that I'll take care of you once you've accomplished that. Charlie's son actually works for me now, if you can believe it.
Some sort of reparation?
No. I knew the Herman struggled after Charlie left town. Once his kid was of age, I offered him an opportunity to provide for his family. I don't hold his father's sins against him. That wouldn't be fair. However, I do let him know not to betray my trust in him. So, that being said, I have another opportunity I'd like to offer to you guys. Interested? I have someone that's left town without paying me. No. I'm not gonna have you guys go hack someone up. I want you to go over to this guy's house and get my money. If you can't find any money at his house, get something else of value. I understand this is your first time doing something like this, so I'll make it easy on you. Break into this guy's house, get my money, and then leave without anyone being any wiser. I'll send you the information soon. Oh, and guys, I wouldn't discuss with Frank what I told you. He's still a little sensitive about his father leaving, if you can believe it.
What an amazing night.
Amazing is a relative term, Q.
You say you don't want to be doing this?
As a matter of fact, no. I don't want to be doing this.
Well, if I remember correctly, this was your idea in the first place. Plus, we just tripled our profits. Aren't you happy with that?
No, I'm not happy with that anymore, okay? I'm not happy being a drug dealer. I'm not happy being asked to rob somebody's house. And I'm certainly not happy with my best friend becoming Scarface.
You know, you're unbelievable.
What's up with Q?
Told him I'm quitting.
You're quitting? Do tell.
Nope. I haven't, Frank. You know, I barely even talk to my girlfriend anymore. I haven't been applying to any jobs in my field. This is taking up all of my focus. And I don't want that lifestyle, man. You said it yourself. And I'm also worried about Q. He's changed.
He does seem really determined.
He has never had to support anyone in his entire life, okay? And I get that he's trying to do right by Riley. But he doesn't have a clue how distant she's become.
Look, I think you guys just need to think about what you're doing. And we'll just give you both.
You know what, Frank? If you weren't so gutless, you would have done the same thing a long time ago. You'd rather leave an unhappy life than face any minute level of conflict. I'm sorry.
No, you're right. But we know that this isn't just a minute level of conflict.
This is the house, Q.
Very funny. Alright, looks like he's not home.
We know he's not home. He's a junkie, of course he's home.
No. Brian told me he's usually at his girlfriend's house about this time.
A guy with a yard like this has a girlfriend, huh? Nice. Leave the car running.
Let's go as fast as possible.
Agreed.
This is what we'll do. I'll check the front, you check the back. If we can't find any money, we'll double back and find something of value. Alright? You didn't find anything? If I was trying to get drunk, maybe, but no, did you? Look, I feel like this guy's most valuable possession is an empty sleeve of holiday Oreos. Okay? Half empty, we might be in business. What are we supposed to take? Honestly, I don't know. Alright, he has to have something of value, right? Or how else would he buy drugs? He has to have something. Maybe use his virtual currency. Sexual favors. I don't know. Wouldn't put it past the junkie. Alright. Okay. We're gonna go together this time. We'll tear the place up if we have to. But we cannot go back empty-handed. Alright? Let's go back here. Let's get the hell out of here.
Agreed.
He tried to kill us, man.
What do you expect, Q? We just took all his money. And his gun.
Sick. Hold it together. I can't believe he shot the car.
My heart cannot take this kind of intensity. My blood pressure has been high for months.
We did what we had to do.
You? I don't know about you, but I didn't think the first thing I'd do with my degree is an armed robbery.
Technically, it wasn't armed robbery, because we didn't arm ourselves until we're in the midst of the robbery, so.
Are you being serious? You're gonna sit here and use a Clintonian definition of right and wrong to make yourself feel better on this one, huh? I'm done.
Here we go. Alright, you know what? Hey, just make sure you call Walt and put in your 2 weeks. I'm sure he'd be fine with it.
This isn't funny, man! What's he gonna do? Chop off my hands and feet?
Yeah, maybe.
I'm gone after we graduate.
Since when? Oh, but hey, don't worry about it. I'm sure Mr. Walt won't care. You know, it's not like you tracked down Papa Herman once he left town.
I got a job. I start in June.
And why didn't you tell me this?
Because I didn't want you to think I was abandoning you in the middle of all this.
No, you know what? honestly, I really appreciate it. It would have been much nicer to just notice you not show up one day.
All I can say is, I can't do this anymore. And I think you need to quit too. I think we both need to quit.
I can't do that, man. I mean, I'm so close. I'm so close to having just...
To having what, exactly? Your body being part of a beaver dam?
You know what, Sean? Not everybody gets stuff handed to them. And you should know that more than anybody. I mean, think about it. Either I could do this for a little while longer and be set, or I stop. And what, I'm drowning in debt? I mean, I don't want to do that.
I would imagine that Riley would rather be married to a broke loser. Yeah. Over a wealthy corpse. Okay? And all of this? It's taking over our lives, man. I want my life back. And I think that if you don't come with me soon, it's gonna be too late for you.
Good to see you again.
Thank you for meeting me on such short notice.
Honestly, I was a little surprised to hear from you.
Well, I wasn't sure you'd want to meet with me after everything that happened.
Well, those things are in the past, but obviously you've got to know that I had no choice in what I had to do.
I don't blame you at all. My life's been a series of bad choices, one after the other.
You know, our bad choices don't have to determine our future.
My future's set. Has been since I was 12. However, the same doesn't have to be said for Walker.
Yes, your nephew's record looks very good. Does he still live with your parents?
Grandparents. His mother left. His father died recently.
I'm sorry to hear that.
His grandparents live off Social Security. I think he could really amount to something if given the chance.
I see.
That's why I'm here. Walker doesn't have to turn out like me.
You know, Walt, online classes are a great way...
I'm not concerned about me. I'm here so Walker has a chance at a higher education.
Okay. I'll take this with me. I'll be gone this weekend, but I'll have an answer to you by Monday.
Thanks for your time.
You, we need to talk. Hop in.
We've got a graduation party, Kev.
It won't take long. It's urgent.
Q, what are you doing?
Be right back.
What's going on? Sean quit.
Who told you that?
Look, we saw you working the drive-in alone, and Walt's becoming suspicious.
Listen, I don't need Sean to
Bro,
make
sure. Your numbers are low, and we need to get you out there. I got drugs on me. Let's go sell them. I got the buyers, and this way I'll get Walt off your back.
You have my graduation cards? What's your problem?
Oh, I don't know, Q. Maybe the fact that you
missed the party. Yeah, I know. Look, I'm sorry.
Oh, don't! There's no excuse. You couldn't even answer your phone
Where the hell were you? And don't say it was a family emergency, because they were all here with me!
You know what? I've had a lot on my mind lately.
Oh, like we all haven't. I've been preparing for my job, helping you find a job, and then moving back home. Oh, I don't even know what to say to you anymore. Oh, I can strangle you.
Riley, don't be ridiculous.
I'm not stupid. Something else is going on. Honestly, I don't even think I want to know.
Well, maybe you don't want to know, Riley, because I'm trying to make this work for us.
Us? Please don't stand there and say you're trying to make this work for us. Have you even met me? All I wanted was to have a life with you. Not an extravagant life, just a life. I don't know what happened to the guy I shared that train with, but you aren't him.
You know what? Maybe that guy's gone. And all that's left is this practical guy that understands what it takes.
All I wanted was you. How old are you?
The old me's gone, Riley! Listen. Alright, I can have all of our problems solved. We won't even be in debt after.
Just go. I'll tell you one thing though. It wasn't worth it. Whatever you were doing. And it wasn't worth losing me.
Riley, listen.
Hasn't been by in quite a while now. Where is Sean?
He didn't make it.
If you don't show up to make a delivery, you don't get a cut. That's how this works. Tell your friend that. You've shown yourself trustworthy, Q. That's why I'm offering you another proposition.
What is it this time?
I want you to rob another house.
I don't know if I...
You don't know what? Look, it'll be easy. Just in and out, nice and fast, just one item, and it'll be there. Take you 5 minutes.
What am I looking for?
I'll send you the information, just like the last time. And just like the last time, you'll need a partner. I never recommend sending anyone in as a lone person. You'll need a lookout. If you can't find anybody else, I'll have Brian here hook you up with one of the other guys. Q, if you do this right, there'll be a big payday for you.
Finished already? I mean, I know it's Wednesday night, but it's only 11 o'clock.
I'm not worried about it. And you know, we can be partners now since Sean's gone.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm getting out too.
Perfect. What about...
I can't live in fear anymore, Q. I mean, Sean's gone. That means I can do it too.
You know, you and Sean are unbelievable. Alright, I'm about to make a big payday and you both get out at the same time. I'm at the end of the track, Frank. I need one more big payday. And Walt gives me a job.
What job?
Robbery.
Oh, because the other one works so well. Why not?
You know what? There's a lot of money into this. And if I could do it right, I'll be out of debt. Done. But there's one problem.
What? Oh, no.
Oh, come on. Sean's gone.
Forget it.
Look, I need you. I just need you to be looking. Alright? This is a low-key operation.
Just like the last one was?
If you don't come with me, Brian's gonna hook me up with one of his guys. And I can't go with someone I can't trust.
And I appreciate that. The answer is no. I can't help you this time, Q. Sorry. But just come get me whenever you want to enjoy a movie.
Outside. They said it was a drunk driver who went the wrong way. Riley, I'm so sorry. I wanted to give you everything. You know, like, I didn't want to let you down. Now I realize that's all I've been doing lately. It's all right. I'm right here. You know what's funny is, before we were together, I never told you this, but I saw you for the first time at a basketball game. It was impossible not to see you. It's like I was drawn to you. I fell in love with you right when I saw you. I fell in love with you instantly. It wasn't before my knee surgery then. That was just the first time I told you. Please forgive me, Riley. I'm so sorry.
Brian. I need Walt's number now. I don't care. I need to talk. It's over, Walt. I'm done. I'm done selling drugs for you at the drive-in. I'm done robbing houses. It's over.
Calm down and listen. I've entrusted you with a lot. I need you to honor your word.
You have my word that you'll never see me again.
What about the last job I just gave you? Are you really willing to turn down that kind of money? Think carefully before you answer.
No amount of money can make me reconsider this, you ignorant prick.
I'm really disappointed by your sudden awakening to morality here. Believe me, Q, I have ways of making your life miserable. Is working for me really that bad?
Burn in hell.
Hey, Scott. Yeah, I'm at the hospital with her now. She overdosed. Yeah, they're getting ready to take her to a recovery facility. Listen, I'm not going to be able to go with you on Saturdays. No. No, I know you wouldn't. But thank you.
Tomorrow we'll finish it all up, and by we, I mean me, because you're not going to do a thing, all right?
All right, sounds perfect.
Yeah, I'm sure it does. By the way, you need anything?
Like what?
I don't know, whatever you want. Ice pack, soup, foot massage.
Oh, that last one sounds good.
So, I looked up some of those links you sent me, and I think I'm going to try for a couple of them.
Really? Which ones?
All of them.
You gonna get that?
No, I don't need to.
It's okay. I need to go to the bathroom anyway.
Alright. What is it?
I just heard about what happened.
And?
And nothing. I'm actually happy for you. You did what was best for you and Riley. I get it.
So you called to congratulate me? Wouldn't a card have sufficed?
I called because you never took your share of the profit that we made together. Remember, graduation day? You know what Walt says, if you're not here to deliver, you don't get to collect.
Listen, Kev, honestly, I told Walt I'd never see him again, and I intend on keeping my word.
Look, I'm not calling for Walt. I'm calling as your friend. You don't even have to go over there. I'll just give you the money tonight before I go over. Just do my friend a solid. There's over $1,000 here, dude.
Alright, where do I meet you?
Everything okay?
Yeah. Yeah, it is. Actually, I have to go get something real quick. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but trust me. I'll be back in 20 minutes, alright?
Right back.
Left.
coming.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were... Can I help you?
Hi, I'm Jack. Are you Riley?
Yes, I am. Who are you?
I'm one of Q's friends from work. I was driving home and I think I saw his car. I think he's been in an accident.
What? I'll get my keys.
You know, I don't mean to pry, but you don't really seem to be in a position to drive. I can take you there if you like.
No, thanks. Wouldn't make me very comfortable. No offense.
None taken. Just trying to help.
Right, thank you.
Jack.
Right, thank you, Jack.
Can I at least lead the way out there so you know where you're going?
Sure, yeah, that'll be all right. That's weird.
What is?
I don't hear any sirens. You said it was a wreck. Did it look bad?
It looked pretty bad. I didn't think anyone had called it in yet, so I made sure to dial 911 before I came over here.
I see. How do you know where I live?
Well, I've dropped Q over here several times after work. He mentioned he had a girlfriend who lived here. Said a lot of nice things about you.
Q always takes his car to work.
Oh!
Kev?
No, this isn't Kev. I told you, didn't I? I told you I would find a way to make your life miserable.
What?
Very good. I'm sorry I haven't been in touch very much recently. Too busy burning in hell and all of that. Oh, by the way, I think I may have someone here that you know. Here. I'm sorry. That was a little hard to decipher there, but I think you get the picture.
You mother...
Careful! I have your girl!
Where are you?
You should know how to find me by now, Q. But I wouldn't suggest you come over here until you do me one little favor first.
The robbery.
Ding, ding, ding! You are right on with the guesses tonight.
I'll send you the address, and you can go there tonight.
I told you I was done.
I don't give a shit! You do this job for me, and you will get your girl back alive tonight. Or you don't do this job for me, and I will take a box knife to your girl here, and you will find her grinning ear to ear on your porch step later tonight. The choice is yours.
I'm gonna kill you.
Threats are one thing, my friend. Here, I'll do you one better. I'll promise that Riley will suffer innumerable tortures before she finally passes on. You know, you never really mentioned how beautiful she really is. I'll send you a text later. Oh, and one more thing, you don't get paid tonight.
Frank, listen, man, I need your help.
I told you to.
No, listen. Walt has Riley. Alright, if I don't do this for you, he's good.
Alright. What do you want to meet?
What is that?
Give me a break. It's the only clean black shirt I had.
Here, take that.
Where are we going anyway?
I'll give you the address. Hopefully you know where it's at, or we can put in the GPS.
Well, I should know where it's at. I lived here all my life.
All right, well, it's 33 Wonderview Avenue.
That's going out of town. You know what? It'd be better if I just drove. What are we supposed to be looking for anyway?
It's an envelope that has the initials D.A. on it.
D.A.? As in district attorney?
As in I have no clue. Let's go.
You remember what we're looking for, right? It's very specific.
An envelope marked DA.
That's right.
You know, Batman would never use a gun.
Don't make me kill you before we get inside.
Let's go as fast as possible.
Agreed.
We gotta look at the rest of the house. We're not going back without it.
What do you want?
We are looking for something. Something we have to have by tonight. We're in a very bad situation. I'm in a very bad situation. If you just listen, I can explain. My girlfriend.
How do I know you won't return again?
That wasn't us. I think I knew who it was and what they want. If you just let me explain.
See, you both are carrying guns, which makes me think whatever it is you're looking for is of great importance. Perhaps you're even willing to die for it. Regardless, you're not walking.
He's telling the truth. We were forced to come here by someone who's going to kill his girlfriend. We're just looking for an envelope.
What envelope? What's in it?
Honestly, we don't know.
Listen, I think I know who lives here. I know your father. His name is Scott. How do you know my name?
Riley. She's your girlfriend, right?
Yeah, how do you know her?
We were friends in college. I went to her graduation party, but you
didn't show, I know.
What's going on? What does this have to do with my dad?
It has nothing to do with your dad. I'm one of the students. I was sitting here to get an envelope.
Why?
They have Riley. They're gonna...
Who has Riley?
A drug dealer named Walt. He has her and he won't give her back to me unless I bring him an envelope.
Let's go get that envelope. Jeez, I hope your friend is still alive.
Guys, I really think I need to go to a hospital.
Don't worry, it's just a grazing.
I said the person who put it there, and this, it's not a grazing.
We'll go once we find it, alright?
It says DA on the front. That's it, right?
That's right. Where was it?
Bathroom.
Alright, we don't have much time. Let's go. Okay. Drop you off at a hospital at the front doors, but I don't have enough time to explain a gunshot wound right now.
That's fine. I'll just call an ambulance after we get Riley back. Besides, Mia says it's not that bad, right?
Hi.
I'll call an ambulance after we get Riley.
You're hardcore, friend. Thank you.
Just put pressure on her, right? Should I have to help her something?
Honestly, I have no idea. I don't even know if they're supposed to keep pressure on it. I just told you that because I see it in the movies.
So what's in the envelope? What is DA looking for?
It looks like a list of names.
You're telling me Riley's life is on the line for a list of names?
I think these are high school students that are being considered for the Diligent Achiever Scholarship. Why would...
He's recruiting.
What?
Why target these kids?
He's targeting the ones on economic hardship. He's promising them the prestige of being a soldier on the street. That's how he got me.
You received this scholarship?
No, I didn't. Well, when I was young, my mom had to take care of all of us. Our family struggled, to say the least, and Walt was the one who offered me a chance to provide for my family.
So we're enlisted to find a cheap labor?
He's taking control of everything from here to Kansas. What better way than with high school kids with no other options?
Well, how would he even know that Dr. Alex offered this scholarship?
Now that, I don't know.
What is Walt's full name?
Walter Donovan. Why?
Dad just said he was meeting with a former student named Donovan. Dad said that he had a relative that he wanted to recommend for the scholarship. Dad said that Donovan had received the scholarship himself.
Your dad met with Walt?
He seemed uneasy about it. The only reason he brought it up was because he was a former student that he had to expel from the campus himself. But he wanted to give Donovan a second chance.
Yeah, he was kicked out for selling on campus. Kevin told me that.
I don't believe this.
I came to college on that scholarship.
Yard?
Yeah.
Give me 5 minutes.
Come through for me, or am I gonna have to use this?
Stop! Stop. I got what you need right here. Hand her over first.
You do not make the decisions! I have the collateral!
You're gonna regret that.
Just bring me the envelope, and your old buddy Kev here will give you your girl.
Hand it over. Don't want to know why I liked you in high school. I'll give it to you.
I told you there'd be a box knife, didn't I?
The boss has another proposition for you.
We're done negotiating tonight. Hand her over.
Am I expected to take this girl seriously?
I've already shot one person tonight. I can handle another. I'd love for it to be this bag of shit standing in front of me.
None of you are irreplaceable. I can always find more. And this will allow me to find numerous willing candidates. However, I get the impression that this girl is irreplaceable. Am I right?
Well, wait. Hey, look. Alright, you don't have to do this. Okay, I just gave you a dozen names. You don't even need me anymore, and you never needed Violet. Most of all, you don't have to do this. Okay, who knew that your actions as a child would lead to this severe of consequences? None of us. But you can't ruin these kids' lives, okay? Give them a chance at life. Avenge your parents' death by giving them that chance. A chance that they deserve and a chance that you deserve. Am I getting through to you, fella?
Here's what's gonna happen, Walt. The police are on their way and they're gonna pick you up. Funny story.
story. I met your friend Brian. He not only let me in the bar, but he actually offered to call the police for me. Nice guy.
I told him to do what the lady asked.
You're going to jail tonight. It was only going to be for drug possession, intent to sell, and kidnapping, which is bad enough as it is. But you had to go ahead and kill Kevin. See, we had no proof that you had killed Charles Harmon. No proof at all. But look at you! You gave us proof, fresh, right here tonight.
Nobody move! Put your hands up! Now, slowly, back away! This one's gone. This guy's alive. Okay, Marty, advise the EMS, bring two stretchers.
Are you okay, son?
Well, I've been shot, so...
Hang in there. We've got EMS on the way. We're gonna be here in a few minutes, okay?
Hello, Walt.
Hey! You stay put. Don't move.
Well, this is a good way for you two to meet. Riley, Frank. Frank, this is Riley.
Watch your head.
Oh. I'll fall behind the ambulance with Mia and meet you there, alright?
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Don't worry about me.
Okay. So you're the one that broke into my house.
I am so sorry, Dr. Allen.
Stop the Dr. Allen stuff. You and I have known each other long enough. You can call me Scott.
So how'd you know about the break-in?
Well, my daughter was.
Right.
She gave me a phone call when she thought intruders were in the house. That's when I started back.
You had to have thought about the worst.
Yeah, I did, but she gave me a phone call about a half hour ago, explained all the stuff.
I didn't realize that...
Oh, that my best friend and daughter are dating?
Yeah. How does...
Does that make me feel?
Yeah.
Well, let's just say it's growing on me.
Are you hurt at all?
Fine, I promise.
Your dad didn't tell me much except that there was a break-in at the house?
It wasn't really a break-in. Well, it was a break-in, but Q and this guy named Frank needed to get in the house for something.
What was it?
Just an item that a local drug lord needed.
Walt.
What?
Go on.
Basically, he needed this item to recruit new members.
Well, why did Q have to do it? How did he get involved?
He was... John Quincy?
Yeah, that's me.
Mrs. White suffered from some minor injuries. It wouldn't have been so bad if she hadn't just been in that car accident.
But she's okay.
Yeah, she'll recover just fine. And Frank? Frank?
Herman? Frank Herman.
Oh, his recovery time will be more substantial. However, considering it was a gunshot wound, I'd say he's pretty lucky.
Thank you, Nurse King.
Mr. Quincy, you can come visit Mrs. White now.
Mr. Herman won't be able to welcome to other resources.
Are you really going through all this again to pressure me into more foot massages?
Mm-hmm.
You're shameless.
I missed you.
You missed me? You just saw me. Remember we were together at that bar when you kicked that guy's face?
No! I missed you.
I know I missed you too.
Did you talk to the police yet?
Yep, me and I have to go down to the station to file a report. I'm sure they'll come by and talk to you and Frank.
What about all that you were involved in? You know, becoming part of a drug ring.
Well,
the only person that can attest against me as well. But since everybody can see his agenda with kidnapping and murder, I think I'll be alright. Plus, I'm done with all that gangster activity now.
Well, that's perfect timing. Here I am in all of this pain. I really could have used something to help you.
And then you say, hey, check this out. This will be where a large pizza.
Good. Sounds like a porno.
I know. That was improv by you, so what does that say?
It just naturally went there.